And it goes a little something like. What up, guys? Welcome back to a brand new episode. Episode number what, Sunny D?
Episode number freaking 82. What up, everyone? What up? Hope you're having a wonderful freaking day. Because, you know, me and my boy, Andre, we are. Andre, I haven't seen you in a while. Where you been at?
Yo, I don't know, bro. I just came here just now, like 5 minutes ago. Yeah, but we've been, what have we been doing? Everything's good. Still in school and stuff like that. Just making sure. Is that thing red?
Yeah.
School and classes. School. I think class got canceled today. Oh, yeah. Crazy. My class got canceled today. The funny thing with school is, bro, we need our vaccination cards.
Yeah.
I just tell them I have it. I have my vaccine. I'm vaccinated, but I just tell them that I don't have it because I don't want to. Think about it, bro. They want me to go to school on Monday. Bro, it's like money being wasted. I'd rather just be at home and just watch, like, study that shit online.
No. Yeah.
So today is September 1st, so today marks a month. 5 days ago, actually, is when my school started. This is deja vu or something? Like, bro, I could have sworn, bro. I was talking about something with 5 days in school. 5 days ago is when school started. But I usually, so, like, we have assignments already. I'm already, like, reading up the books and stuff, so. We on a roll, baby. We on a roll. Wubba lubba dub dub.
School.
Rick and Morty, baby.
I feel like this is the best time to go to school because everything is on Zoom.
Exactly. Right? Yo, take the advantage, guys, to go right now to you know, go to school. Take that, you know, use it to your advantage and use it to.
Yeah, all my classes, abilities. I looked like 80% is Zoom and 20%.
Oh, yeah? 80% Zoom?
80%.
Well, that's good. Yeah. Oh, so you going to Vaughn or what?
Yeah, Vaughn College.
You're going to Vaughn College. And congrats to you, bros. Clap it up. Oh, no, that's the wrong one.
Bro, what the heck?
There we go. My son Sonny, bro. Yeah, congratulations to you, bro. We definitely, my son Sonny, going back to school, taking classes. Yeah, bro. But other than that, speaking about something that just came up, Kanye West, bro, dropped a crazy album. Funny thing is, I haven't listened to it. I know neither have you.
Yeah, I hope it's not crappy. His music back then was dope.
Yeah, right?
Now the music he's making is like, I don't really like it.
It's a goofy.
It's weird,
right? Okay, yeah, no, I agree with you. Because with me, it's like, I know the old Kanye. Now it's the new Kanye. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like, whoa. Old Kanye, they were like Heartless. You know, remember Heartless? How could you be so hard? Mm-hmm. That was the shit back then, bro.
I don't know why he changed himself.
I don't know, bro. It's like the change of times.
That's what happened when you joined the Illuminati.
Illuminati? You think he's in the Illuminati? Maybe.
I don't know.
We don't know, bro. Kanye. But, I don't know if you know, Kanye West, I think he postponed his album drop for a while. Mm. So I think he's supposed to drop his album like last month or something. I'm not sure. But the reason why Kanye West is a businessman, bro. Think about it. He made y'all, people that don't know about Kanye West, now all of a sudden know Kanye West and Donda. The word Donda, bro.
What's Donda mean? I was here on Twitter.
I don't know.
It's just like Donda.
That's his album name. So, As a person, you know, in the music industry, if you just drop an album without having eyes on it, you're gonna drop and no one's gonna pay attention, right? Mm-hmm. But if you create calamity, if you create, like, I guess you could say chaos, because people are like, yo, just drop it already.
Yeah.
You know, people want to hear. So when you create that type of suspense, it gains more traction. And I think Academics posted up on his IG that he's going to sell around 300,000 copies. Which is a lot, actually, because not a lot of people buy copies, right?
Yeah, nobody
buys. Nobody buys copies, but he's projected to make on sale for 300,000 copies, which is a lot for an album drop. That's a huge amount of number, you know. I think 6ix9ine is also another like person that when he drops music, like, it's a lot of people buy his copies.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
So guys, we're gonna go through a rundown. Through Kanye West's album. Today's podcast is going to be a reaction. reactionary podcast, more so reaction video.
Well, it's like a small segment.
It's small segment. It's not the whole thing.
Yeah, it's like, well, how long are we keeping it?
We probably gonna bring, you know, like 25 minutes.
Nah, a little less than that.
20 minutes. Like 20 minutes of Donda.
10, 15 minutes.
Of Donda? All right.
Because of music, because we can't just do music. Remember, we're a podcast.
Oh, we're facts.
We're not a review.
Okay.
Right?
I feel you. All right, so
this will be like a small segment.
This will be a small segment. 10 to 15 minutes, guys, starting from now. What time is it? 9:50? I'm just kidding. I don't know what time it is. Yeah, but all right. Yeah, you got the time, so you know.
8:30.
All right, sounds good. So the first one he got put on to Donda from Kanye West, 2021 album. It's called Donda Chant, you know. So
this will be like our review.
Yeah, let's see. Let's see how long this is.
Donda, 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 Donda.
That's how it starts.
Donda, 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 Donda.
I feel like I'm getting some double chat in my ear. Donda, Donda, I don't trust the negative energy.
Wait. In the name of Jesus. Come on.
I feel like it's like, I don't know. When I don't understand words or why they're saying it, I feel like there's like a subliminal message that these artists give. Uh-huh. So I get kind of, I just listening to it, I'm getting freaked out.
Okay. So I heard a little. It's called Donda Chant. Donda Chant. I think it just goes on for that for like another 5 minutes. 2 minutes. Okay, let's see. Look.
Donda, Donda, Donda.
Seems like some suburban.
Donda.
D-O-N-D-A.
D-O-N-D-A.
And then chant. Bro, this dude wildin', bro. Start fucking out. No, but I think from what I seen in the news, and I don't know if this is fake news or not, you guys could fact check me on this, is the Donda chant, you know what it's referring to?
What?
The heartbeat of his mother before she's dying.
Mm.
So it's like dun dun.
Well, dun there's dun, gonna be a conspiracy dun, dun. Theory about this.
I'm pretty sure, bro. I think that's the conspiracy right now. That's why, like, it sounds like her heartbeat. So that's why, like, towards the end, it sounds like this.
Donda, 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 Donda.
That was it. And this is a new song. Bro, this dude is bugging. He put his deceased mother's heartbeat on an album. Oh, the dude bugging out, bro.
OD.
Who does that, bro?
That's too much. I don't know. I get freaked. I was just listening to it. I started getting freaking out because I'm like, yo, this is some kind of like subliminal message he's trying to put into my ear. So when I'm sleeping, I'm probably like.
He started bugging out, bro. I feel you. Yeah, so that was the first one. All right, so I guess now we're getting into like the juicy, the nitty gritty. But how many songs he has? Let's see. So he has a chant. I don't think that counts as one. That's just like an intro. Mm-hmm. Usually, like most albums have an intro.
Yeah.
And like Chef G, he has an intro where like he just talks. And it's not like a full song. It's like maybe like a minute or so.
Oh, yeah.
So I think they sell it at the bottom. Oh, he has 27 songs. But the minus the Donda chant. So it's 26 songs. Altogether, it's like an hour and 50 minutes. So, but it's funny though. I don't know if you noticed, but Kanye West likes to post and like talk about like Jesus and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. He makes like gospel songs.
He makes like gospel music, right? That's from what I understand. But bro, you know who he invited to his stage? You invited Marilyn Manson.
Who's that?
This dude. He was like all like he's pale white, and I don't personally know him. Obviously, I don't, but. When I saw him, people was posting up on Facebook and Instagram how he was burning the Bible.
I don't know. That's crazy. I know, like,
I'm saying,
I get. I don't know, like, when I listen to stuff like that and like the things he's doing now, because I watch his YouTube videos, and like he's in the gospel, and then they're all wearing like white, all wearing black, and they sing like Christian songs, right?
Yeah.
But I don't know. I always get an eerie feeling. Like, I'm like, this is, and like, when I start hearing that, I'm like, oh man, this feels weird. Yeah. I want to see how it sounds.
It's like off.
Yeah, it's weird.
whatchamacallit? Oh, snap. It's a one time thing. All right. So,
let's see his songs.
Let's see. So we have ourselves, I don't know. You want to choose or you want to just go in chronological order?
What do you think? Isn't he known for something? This was that one song that everyone likes. Isn't that one song that everyone was talking about?
I know that there's one where he's doing with Favio Foreign. Like he's a drill rapper, but all right, so let's go on to it. It's called Off the Grid. I heard a little bit of it, but Sonny hasn't, so let's check that out.
No, drill rapper, that's different.
Yeah. Boy. We off the grid, grid, this for my kid.
Bro, see, I like this.
Kids have kids. Everything we did for the crib. Everything we did, how we live. All this smoke got a scent. All that smoke, Kevin sent. Everything I spoke, what I meant. Never disguise my intent. Lies outside the event. Brought my life out the trench. God, thank God, look what he did. We off the grid.
I'm off the grid. Got tats on my ribs. Tattoos on my ribs. I just tell my kids. I just do 20 county. We was an honest. I just bought me some brand new clothes. Dover Street Market.
What do you think about it so far? The beginning of that song.
I like it, but I feel like there's like a deep message. You know, because Kanye West, he makes deep messages like. You know, it's not more like, it's more like you try to understand what he's trying to say, you know?
That we're trying to portray.
Yeah. But it's not like those regular songs where it's like a beat like Justin Bieber.
Yeah. Right.
It's not like
off the grid.
Eye catching. Like, I sound like.
Like something like you'll get, like, you're catchy to and you're like, oh, you'll sing it, like, you know, mm-hmm. like that one song with Justin Bieber and who's that white kid? Kid Laroi.
Yeah, Kid Laroi.
Yeah. I get fucked up, everybody. Yeah, everyone's doing that, you know? That's catchy.
No.
Let's stick to the part where I think Fabio sings a little bit. I think this one.
Yeah, I want to hear Fabio.
Y'all only witnessed it. Yeah, they changed the beat. Turn into a this trip. Going grid, Texas, G sticks. Lit in 76. Changes up the flow. We off the grid. Yeah, look. When I was in jail, I was low key. Shout out to supporters that wrote me. Eat food, work out, and then go sleep. You know, I'm praying he carrying both feet. No, we got God with us. He look at me and see a God figure. And when I stop vibing, I know that he with me. And I'ma always catch a. What's the name of the song? Off the Grid.
Off the Grid.
Kanye West. What's funny is he didn't put featuring Favio Foreign. This dude just said off the grid Kanye West. And I think there was a girl who sang in the beginning. You heard that girl?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. Fuck that bitch, bro.
He didn't put
no features, bro. What's funny, you know? But let's keep continuing. I want to hear like the rest of Favio's. I know it's demons in that dark liquor. We buy a bottle of squash. Switch up everybody, turn into a horse. But my pocket's bigger and my heart richer. My mind smarter, my grind harder and my car quicker. I'm at her in church, she pray for me. She my God sister. Yeah, I'm only trusting the people I keep close. Telling they sold for a repo. Remember when I was broke wearing cheap coats. And I was diamonds and houses and C-notes. I'm feeling marvelous. Let the monster loose. They call me a product of my environment. I tell them no, I'm a God producer. Defense good and the guards can shoot. I put them on you, make it hard to move. Tattoo on my face is the mark of truth. Gotta watch what you say when they mark you. I already predicted this. Y'all only witnessed it. Look, got a couple old friends that I'm not really clicking with. I know they pray that we settle our differences. I pray that they lower all my senses. I got some demons I'm not even dealing with. They ain't feelings I'm not really feeling. And I know some members that get back their membership. You switched up. Like, how you not feeling me? I act like I care, but I don't really care. Now I live in a new building with amenities. I got a new ceiling with a chimney. I got a few moves when it
finish me. I don't get too friendly with the enemy. You gotta move different when you in the industry. You gotta move different when you in the industry. You gotta move different when you look. God bless me with amazing grace. She fell alone my day to day. I just want
gosh damn, this dude's he's been singing for like 2-3 minutes. You know what? Yo, Favi, good thing, man. Good thing. Man, them things.
He's nice. He's nice.
That's nice, right? But it's crazy how Kanye flipped it. He flipped it from your original, like, old school beat, old school trap beat, into drill.
Because you know what's popping. Drill is popping right now.
Yeah, drill is popping right now. He chose Favio for a reason, I think. That's good. Yo, if you were to rate this song, you could finish it on your own time. But, like, for as of right now, if you were to rate this song, like, out of a 10, 10 being, like, pretty good.
Six.
I give it like an 8.
I give it a 6.
I like the beginning, right? The beginning is like,
but you gotta know, like, I have different tastes in music.
Yeah, no, for sure.
So the song is not bad, but what I would give it was like, would I listen to it? Probably not again, you know?
Yeah, probably like a one-time thing. I'll probably just like, this is the type of song like when you listen to it, like, yeah, and then you get hype around Favi's part and then that's it. But like, it's not a song that you like, I'll tell you what, Pop Smoke, Dior, you could always go back and you're like, oh, that shit's catchy, bro. Because think about it, that's a pioneering, he was technically a pioneer in that. And he's like, it was a revolutionary song.
Yeah.
You know, like, bringing that to New York and like, yo, get people moving.
That beat and like the way he says his lyrics, because like the lyrics, it might be good, but if it's not up with the beat, then because you want people to you want to make a song that people could replay.
Yeah,
you know,
that makes sense. Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is the second time I heard of it.
Who's good at that? A Boogie's good at that. Yeah. Pop Smoke.
J.I. is really good at that. Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber's really good at that.
Well, you can have it on repeat and you're like, oh, like you will never get.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I've noticed? There's a Korean rapper, Jay Park.
Yeah.
Jay Park and all Korean rappers, mad Spanish girls listen to them, bro.
Yeah, Spanish and black girls.
I didn't know this, bro, because I was looking through in the comments and I was like, oh, blah, blah, blah. This girl spoke Portuguese from Brazil. Another girl from Spain. I was like, yo, Spanish people be listening to these kind of. I was surprised. He was singing in English. It was a song, Dedication. He was singing in English, but it just caught me off guard and struck me by surprise. I was like, oh, snap. There's actually females that actually listen to songs that are not from their origin country.
Yeah.
I was surprised.
I like listening to Spanish music.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. Yeah, I'm going to pass you the phone. I'm going to let you choose the next one.
I'm going to.
You choose it.
DG.
You got
DG.
Mad songs. Only got mad songs, bro. But yeah, Off the Grid, it's not bad. Out of a 10, 8, I vibe with it. Not too shabby.
What?
Broke a iPad, ain't funny like
just
that. It get ugly like that, can't get no money like that. Holy Father, please let me step in. Can't talk to buddy like that, it get bloody like that. Whole lot of steppers and they step in. It ain't sunny like that, and they coming right back. And when you on tour, I bet you check in. Cause my guys back to work, it's a Monday like that. And when you text, change the beginning of every word. You will speak to me with only no cap. Me and your big homie go back. Homie don't rap, you don't know me like that.
Who's here when I need a shoulder to lean on? I hope you're here when I need them demons to be gone.
I give it a 7.
A 7 out of 10? I see where you're getting the catchy. Like, yeah, I see what type of music catchy, you like.
But
Jonah.
Give it 7 out of 10.
Give it 7 out of 10. Whatchamacallit? This is not more of my vibe. I could vibe with it, so I'm going 50-50 with this one. I'm giving it
a five out of ten.
5 out of 10, cause it's more of a mood thing. Like if I'm feeling like that vibe, be like trying to go on a ride kind of thing, I'll blast that in the car. But then like I'm not gonna like, it's not a get hype song, bro.
Yeah,
definitely not a get hype song, bro. Definitely not a get hype. But I mean, Jonah, you guys know about biblical text. Jonah is the guy who got swallowed up by that whale. What happened was he was trying to, I'm going to give you some biblical story time. God was like, yo, Jonah, preach to the people of Nineveh. And then Jonah was like, nah, they deserve to die.
Damn.
And then, so he went the other way. He went to Tarsus. And then God was like, word, you're going to flee by ship? Say less. So what happened was there was a storm, right? And when the storm happened, they were like, oh, they figured, oh, if we threw one of us out, the storm would calm. So they had to draw sticks. They draw sticks out of it. The one with the shortest stick loses. Mm-hmm. And Jonah chose the shortest stick. And he got swallowed up by a big ass. They call it a big whale, obviously, because it's a big fish. So we're going to classify it as a whale. Whale ate him up and then threw him on shore to go preach the word, like, yo, repent. So, and then, he got tight because he didn't want them. He didn't want God to like tell them to say that they were sorry, you know?
Yeah.
He didn't want to happen. He was like, you just killed him, you know? Reckless. But that's the story of Jonah.
Jonah.
So let's see. He has a song called Heaven and Hell. He has a song called Keep My Spirit Alive. He has a song called Jesus Lord. Yo, this is
I think you said that Drake came out with an album.
Oh no, Drake is gonna come up with that. I'm telling you, it's called Certified Lover Boy, I believe. CLB.
Certified Lover Boy.
Yeah, he posted up something on IG with like it's like 9 baby mamas with their pregnant.
Oh damn!
So the baby's about to come out, which is the album. Very good, very good. there's some problems going on with Drake and Kanye, you know?
Like beef?
Yeah, Kanye. People don't know Kanye's a troll.
Yeah, he's a
crazy troll. You can see it in his character. He's a funny guy. Come on, think about it, bro. When everyone knows when Taylor Swift went up, right, to receive a reward, right? I think her music award or something like that. And then Kanye was like, "Yo, Taylor, I'm not gonna cut you off. Your music was good on you and all, but Beyonce had like that's a troll right there, you know?
Yeah,
very trollish. But yeah, let's see. Now we have Jesus Lord. We have Jesus Lord. We have Jesus Lord Part 2. Let's see Jesus Lord, and then
he's into gospel, right?
He's into gospel. I mean, it's
you don't sound like gospel.
It does. Very worldly. All right, let's try Jesus Lord. Oh hell no! Got the organ in the background.
Deepest end. It's just drugs, it ain't no hugs, it ain't no love there. You've been down so much you don't even know what's upstairs. Suicidal thoughts got you wondering what's up there. And why they introduce a party, they say it's up there. Too many pills, so much potion, so much pain, too many emotions. And everything that you do good, it just go unnoticed. Did they tell you that you good and just stay focused? Mama, you was the life of the party. I swear you brought life to the party. When you lost your life, it took the life out the party. That woman rode with me like a Harley. Visions of my cousin in the cell really scarred me. Moving to the hood was like signing up for the army. Cause they been killing since watching Barney. You want dreams to come true, but I had nightmares. Cause if that come to life, then I might not be right here. Been in the dark so long, don't know what the light here. But I'm just reaching for the stars like Buzz Lightyear. And now I'm light years ahead of those nightmares. I deaded those night tears when the night clears. And if I talk to Christ, can I bring my mother back to life? And if I die tonight, will I see her in the afterlife? But back to reality where everything's a tragedy. You better have a strategy or you could be a statistic. Little boy dies, he just wanted a mystic. And mama steady crying cause she really the victim. Now she's getting high and she's getting addicted. And an older boy just stuck with the picture, painted vivid. That's a family portrait. And a daughter just absorbed it. 16, pregnant, baby daddy said she should abort it, but we can't afford it. So she decides to move forward. Baby shower time, father didn't show up. Now she just feeling nauseous like she finna throw up. The water flows down her legs, yeah, it's finna go up. A year then went by, her daughter just turned one. And she's still depending on her mom. Big brother in the streets, he went and bought him a gun. He want revenge cause the pain feeling numb. And her mom's still doing drugs, cause that's the only time she feel love. Is it real love? Do the scars really heal love? From all the-
this is the best song, yeah.
Right?
I give this like 9 out of 10.
9? Yeah, oh, yeah?
This was good. It was really good.
I understand the type of lyrics he's trying to portray. But I think he's like mentioning Kim in this video, in this song.
No.
Cause bro, he was talking about like his mom, like mama wanted an abortion. I think Kim wanted an abortion.
No. He's okay.
Cause he's talking about his daughter.
No. He said, I think he's mentioning like a tragic family or maybe his family, but not Kim. Because he said, son passed away and died. So the mother became depressed and coped with drugs and then got addicted to drugs. Then she mentioned like, I think like the daughter that got pregnant at 16.
Yeah.
That couldn't afford abortions. I think he was talking about like a regular family.
Oh,
because I know Kim didn't, I know Kim's mother's not a drug addict.
No, I know Kim's mother's not a drug, but I'm saying that from all like the news and stuff like that, I think he was talking about Kim because I remember he was, I don't know if it was a video where he was trying to run for campaign, like some, he was like, my wife almost tried to kill my kid. He says some shit like that. I guarantee, I'm not bugging out because I know I heard him say it.
What's the name of this song?
This is called Jesus Lord.
Oh, Jesus Lord.
The first one. There's three parts. There's this one, part one and part two. So what the, I mean, we obviously have to listen to it on our own time, but we just randomly picking out of the bunch, you know. I think we have one more, we could choose one more, and son, you're gonna choose this last one. But so far, yeah, I mean, the type of music that he's portraying out there is music and songs, motion and poetry. What I mean by that is like regular daily lives that we go through, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you know, it's cool because people that listen to songs like this, they can relate. I know people that are struggling to make ends meet, young teenagers that are just, you know, getting pregnant and they're trying to make an abortion, you know, even though it's, you know, totally up to them. I don't say nothing too contradictory. But yeah, this is just normal life.
Yeah.
The way that he's singing this song.
I'm looking at the lyrics now. He was talking about, I don't think he was talking about Kim.
Oh, yeah?
He was talking about, because he was talking about like what happens in life for a lot of people, like tragedy.
Yeah.
As far as like those lower income.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But I don't think, because I know they didn't grow up like that. Kim. Maybe Kanye. I don't know Kanye's life. I don't think he's talking about him.
All right.
He's just talking about a tragedy of life.
Right, right.
All right. So, well, that's already the third song that third song. We have one more, and after that, we're going to move on from this little segment.
24.
What's the song called?
24.
Welcome to Sunday Church Morning, ladies and gentlemen. Can I just get an amen?
Bro, we in church right now.
I love songs like this. I could listen to like gospel.
Oh yeah.
Because it's like a certain energy I get from it. You know, it feels good.
I'm gonna be completely honest, bro. I got shivers. Yeah. Like I got goosebumps. That's what they
right
call
song.
It. Oh yeah, you did choose the right song. I gotta save that. So we listened to 24, Off the Grid.
Jonah.
Jonah was alright, you know. And Jesus Is Lord, the one where it started off mad eerie, but then it just took off.
But I think so far this is the best one.
24 is the best one for you?
Yeah. Like me,
wow.
I love gospel song. Like when I go to church, I love going to, you know why? Like I like going to Orange's.
National Weather Service, a flash flood warning is in effect. My bad, bro.
Imagine when there's like, oh, a nuclear bomb is coming your way.
Oh, heck no, bro.
I think I try to beat by me fast as I can.
What? You're trying to finish off quick. Oh, man. Nah, but yeah, that was just random, right?
Yeah. No, it happens, yeah. But I saw mad lightning behind you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I just see mad lights.
Oh, goodness, I didn't see. Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, like, I like gospel song. Oh, hey, real quick, go to, type in, I think it's Kanye. It's Never Would Have Made It, and It's All About You.
Never Would Have Made It?
Yeah.
It's on the Donda one? No.
No, it's a different song, but it came out, I think, like last year.
Never Would Have Made It. Oh, by Marvin Sapp? Or by who?
Put Justin Bieber.
Never would. never would have made it?
Yeah, Justin Bieber. Justin. I think he was performing in Kanye West's Sunday service.
Nah. Oh, on YouTube?
Yeah, on YouTube. Yeah. YouTube.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, I was like, whoa, it's not on Spotify. Never would.
Justin Bieber. I think he was performing on Kanye West's Sunday service.
Oh yeah, all right. Let's see this.
This is why I like the gospel song. This song is mad nice. Justin Bieber killed it.
Never would have made it. Oh Lord.
It's totally. I think that's why I want to go back to church.
The song, really? Oh, it's you can hear church gospel already.
This Sunday service, Kanye West Sunday service.
Wow. He sings or no?
Yeah. This is Justin Bieber.
Yeah, this is Justin Bieber.
Skip it a little bit if you want. I like the part where it's all about. Why'd you hear it? Josh! I like that it's all about you part. Gonna come. We're right here.
What is this one?
The chorus people is gonna sing with him. Mm-hmm. It's gonna come soon. That's when I'm like, yo, this song is mad nice. It's gonna come soon. He goes, it's all about you. Where's the backup people? Oh, he's gonna come after this, actually. It's all about you. No, it's not about me. Say it's all about you.
It's all about you.
It's not about me. It's not about me. It's all about you. You. It's not about me. It's all about you. It's not about me. It's crazy, eh?
Yeah, music, bro.
It's all about you. It's not about me. Set me free. Stop it now if you want.
Yeah, that was crazy.
That was nice, right?
That was nice. That was, yeah, wow.
It's all about you.
Yeah, no, the chorus part. So when you're in church and you have a chorus group, mm-hmm. It makes the song 10 times better. So think about it like this, like a chorus, right? Like so when what we've been taught in church is that when you go to heaven, it's all about praise and the glory of God, right? Jesus, mm-hmm. God the Father. And we are essentially doing this, just praising the Lord. That's it. For me, as a person who plays a piano in the church and hearing that, it's different, you know? It's like, whoa, it's like, because some piano players, when you play, like music in itself, obviously is just sound and frequency, right? Yeah. Just sound, that you're just listening to sound. But certain vibrations, you would say, certain vibrations, when you hear them, it's soothing, and then you get that like, oh, like, mm-hmm. What do you call that? Like that feeling, that goosebump feeling. You're like, oh snap, you know, it feels like
chills.
Yeah, chills.
Yeah,
and you feel refreshed, you know. And I don't know how you feel, like, maybe that's how you like gospel. You like it, so
I get that feeling, like, ooh, that it's like a happy energy.
Yeah. I'm feeling it right now, bro. Maybe it's because of the AC too. I don't know. Maybe that's playing a
part. No,
it
definitely gives you that vibes.
I feel
when you
bro.
Listen to gospel.
That's
you
crazy.
Feel like it's. That's why, like, I always like going to that church on Friday. I forgot the name.
The Rock.
The Gate.
The Gate. There you go. The Gate.
The Gate. Yeah. So I really liked it because of the music and then listening, and there was a bunch of people. And it was fun. That's why because they spoke English, you know. Because when I go to Andre Church is good, but they speak like Indo. So it's like, it's kind of just me sitting there looking dumb.
That's why
I like going to like churches that like I understand, because I want to understand, you know.
Yeah. Yo, matter of fact, bro, I didn't even know this, but my mom put me on. You know how now it's mostly like online technological advances and things like that. You can watch sermons online, bro.
Yeah.
You can literally watch sermons online. Yeah. And
you know who I tune into? I tune into one in Philadelphia.
What?
Yeah, them Facebook.
Get out of here. This dude keeping it. Really?
Yeah.
Wow,
I tune in.
Bro.
I just watch. So sometimes they go live. Oh. And Omori, sometimes he goes live, but he does it for the music part.
Yeah.
So sometimes I click and I look at it.
Okay.
But sometimes I tune in the Philadelphia one.
Oh, the Indonesian Philadelphia one? Oh, yeah?
The one that Ezekiel Pastor, and them.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Whatchamacall? You could tune into whatchamacall. There's a pastor named Joseph Prince is a pastor that my mom like fondly like. She loves the teachings that he gives. You know, she doesn't necessarily love him. It's just more of, you know, he's a messenger. You know, You don't want to treat a messenger or a pastor like as if they're like a godlike entity. They're not. They're messengers. We're all messengers. Mm-hmm. And when it comes down to things like that, when you're listening to a messenger and you can connect, you can connect 100% with the message that just, you know, God spoke to you through that messenger, and that's a good thing. So he's one. Bishop T.D. Jakes is another one. Trust me, I'm trying to get into this too. You know,
are you you ever think you? I feel like you'll be a good pastor.
Oh, I don't know about that, buddy.
No. Look, listen. I feel like, first of all, you know how to speak Indonesian and English, right?
Broken Indonesian.
Yeah.
but still,
like, you grew up around it, so you know a lot of. And I feel like you might be able to do something a little bit different than, like, those regular. You'll be more, like, because you will know how to attract people. Because I follow some TikToks on, they're, like, I think they're pastors, but they're young pastors.
Right.
And they use, and I think I remember one guy, he had like a $20 bill.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, he scrunched it. Like, he asked the girl, would you take it? She's like, yeah. Does it more. He stomps on it. Would you take it? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Punches on it.
Mm-hmm.
And he kept on doing that. He's like, you know why she'll take it? Because you yourself, you do not lose value. This is what God made you. And he was saying like that. And I was like, oh, like, I like the analogy.
The analogy.
And everyone was getting hype. Mm. And then he started singing out of nowhere. And I was like, oh damn, I like this guy. Like, I would go to his church.
Oh yeah.
Like, okay. I'm like, yo, where is he? But like, you know, like, I would go to his church. It's like,
you have him saved on TikTok or something?
Huh?
Or you have him saved on one of you? No,
it just pops up.
Oh, it just pops up.
Because I watch it. So it's on the part of my algorithm.
Yeah, with the
other booty shaking girls.
So we watch booty shaking videos.
It's my algorithm.
As well, follow Jesus Christ. Oh my Lord.
It's like small waist, pretty girl with a big bang.
Oh, what? Yo, TikTok is crazy, bro. TikTok, who else be posting that other than?
Then the next slide is
Jesus Christ.
I'm like, God damn it. That's my algorithm.
I feel you. They want you to choose a side. You wanna see, you know, girls with a big banker. You wanna thank the Lord for all he's done. But yeah, man. I mean, to rewind it a little bit, Donda's not bad. It's a pretty good album. It's pretty good.
We're not done with the topic. Huh? You ever think about being a church pastor?
Oh.
You'll be good. And I feel like you might do a little bit better than your dad. Not to like bashing your dad, but I feel like you will have a bigger following. Like, you'll have a bigger church. And like, I will, like, personally at that. I know Tyrone will come. I know mad people will come.
That's tough, bro.
It's a different route.
It is.
It's a different route, but like, I don't know. Cause I know you, of course, you grew up around it. So I'm like, I ever thought like if it will like cross your mind. Like,
you just gave me chills, bro. I just thought about it. I'm like, whoa, that's, I mean, listen, man, like, listen.
How do you become a pastor?
I feel like, to be honest, you could either study for it, right? Like if it was a, because church in general is a nonprofit, you know, like you don't make profit from it.
Yeah, you don't make
most
profit.
Of it is just donations, you mm-hmm. know? It's as if you were giving to charity. But what I'm saying is that's not the purpose of church. The purpose of church is religion purposes, you know, like,
yeah, like spreading the word.
Spreading the word and also like getting in touch with yourself. And I don't see it as a cult. It's more of like a group of people that have a collective understanding mm-hmm. and share the collective ideas
yeah.
and beliefs, right? Same thing applies to Buddhism, Taoism, Islam, you know what I'm saying? It's a collective of people that agree with that. And extremists are the ones that take it crazy far, you know? And it's like, bro, like that's why you have jihadists. You know, they believe in Islam, but Islam doesn't preach hatred, or Islam doesn't preach like, you know? So those are the extremists. But all in all, if I see myself doing it, right now I could say no.
Probably when you're older.
But like, I'm scared, to be honest.
You really?
I'm scared.
If you really become a pastor, of course I will go every day, because now you're speaking English, you know. You're speaking English, and then, you know, like, and I will learn, you know, because you know more than me. You read the Bible every day, probably.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you've been reading when you're young. So me, like, easily, like, I will come. I'm sure, like, many other people will come. And of course, it's for a good reason. I know you're not doing it for anything bad, you know?
Yeah.
But I'm like, I could see like either you as a pastor, because I'm like, damn, like I think Andre would be a good pastor. Because of your dad, because you have your, you know, your dad is a pastor, bro.
Right.
So if anything, you have like the, kind of like, if your father was a Hokage, then most likely you're probably going to become a Hokage. You know what I'm saying?
Got that Naruto reference, you know? Bro, I get
you. If your brother and your family, they're like the Uchiha, then most likely you're going to become Uchiha.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Obviously. I don't know, bro. To be honest, like when it comes down to like the religious route and becoming a pastor, I don't know. People keep saying it like, yo, bro, you could become a pastor, study to be a pastor. I'm like, I don't know. I feel like it's going to be a calling. It's got to be a calling. Something has to drive me. Like again, like, you know, with the whole you and
I mean, still
situation.
Young.
I'm still young, you know, so I don't know my like, route.
I think it's because it's, I think you will be good at it. That's what I think.
Yo, what's crazy is my dad evangelizes, bro. And I'm like, I think I'm the opposite of my dad, bro. Like, I be talking. But I'm saying, like, I try to speak positivity, you know. But, like, my dad evangelizes, you know, like, speaks on the streets, you know, and preaches the word of God on the street. And I'm just like,
I feel like you don't have to do that to be a pastor.
No, for sure.
Because you got to understand, him being a pastor, he has different ways of what he thinks is better for people to like come to church and mm-hmm. to spread up the word of God. You might have a different belief. Maybe you don't have to be in a train. You don't have to be in, because you come from a younger generation. You know, that's back in the days where people were standing in the street and there was preaching the word of God. And he's still, that's his old ways of thinking. You might be different. You're like, okay, how can I bring my message? What's popping right now? Internet, TikTok, YouTube. How can I spread the word of God? You know, doing live Twitch streams, you know, all goes to donation. Yeah. So you have that younger generation and you have that better understanding of, I don't have to be in a train because it's kind of dumb. There's crazy people that I'm risking my own life just to do this. Like, there's better ways to do it. And there's probably more effective ways of doing it. That's how I feel like, you know what I'm saying, right?
I get you. That makes sense. That makes 100% sense. And yeah, just, it's more of, for me, how I see it, it's more of a calling, you know, because I do understand that my dad is a pastor and all that. And I know we, you know, our past videos, we used to do videos on the street as well, like man on the street type of interviews, and we talk to people, but we were reckless, you know. It's more of so like we're reckless and it's and asking people questions and stuff like that. But at the end of it all, I leave it up to God. Trust me, bro. Like I don't know where my future lies from here on out in regards to that specific topic and that journey. Maybe I might come across it, maybe not. Maybe I might just be your average businessman, you know?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, if God decides to do what he did to Jonah and be like, no, you're not becoming a business, you're going to become a pastor. And he tells me to become a pastor. obviously I'm not gonna deny God's, you know, God, you're right, bro. Don't strike me down. Don't smite me, God. Like, all right, yeah. I got you. You want me to pass? All right, I'll be a pastor. I'll do it to the best of my capabilities. But as of now, you know, I'm following my path, doing my things, you know. But at the end of the day, with the songs we listen to, we're all,
yeah,
all the glory to be God.
What's crazy is that the reason that you brought up Kanye, because this whole time I thought you were talking about Drake. I'm like, oh, we're gonna about to listen to Drake.
Yeah.
When you started talking about Kanye, I'm like, oh, we're listening to Kanye.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's crazy because like this past week, I was thinking about like, yo, I want to go back to church.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. That's but like, I was thinking about going to the, like, I was trying to look at the gate, you know, the
yeah.
gate. So I want to understand, you know.
Exactly. Exactly.
So I'm like, yo, I don't care. Like, I'll go alone.
Yeah. You know, exactly, I don't mind. Bro. Let me tell alone. You about going alone. You know, Kaylee.
Mm-hmm.
So Kaylee. Tell your sister.
Like, oh yeah, Kaylee. Yeah.
So Kaylee was like, oh bro, you know, like I've been. I feel like I haven't had any alone time with myself. And I feel like I've been, you know, just, you know, been working, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, I need my time alone. So she told me, like, yo, I'm going to go to the beach alone. I laughed at her. I was like, what? Like, why would you go to the beach alone? It's a more of a friend kind of thing. But then when she was explaining herself to me, she was like, oh, you know, I want to go to the beach alone. You know, it's not bad to be alone sometimes, to be in your own space and to have that sort of collective mind just be at peace, be at ease with yourself. Mm-hmm. So she did it. And I was proud of her. She didn't, no car, just straight bus, public transportation. She did it. She came back home. I was like, nice. Wow, how did you feel? She's like, yeah, I feel amazing.
Yeah.
What was that? That was lightning?
It became all white.
Oh, GG. Bro, did it tell you about when I was working at Poncha and then lightning went through the restaurant?
Really?
Did I tell you?
How?
Okay. This is quick. Let's do this in 1-2 minutes and we'll get to wrapping. It's 51, but we'll get to wrapping quick. Cool. So basically it was raining. It was Hurricane Henry, whatever. So people was outside eating, right? And I was like, man, well, these guys are crazy. But lightning struck. It literally stuck the ground in front of Ponche, where the casita is, the little. So, and I saw people get up. People in the front, they got up.
Yeah.
But when I was inside, I looked towards the outside, towards the window, and literally I saw pure white. Like, you see that's white, right? You could tell that's white. But bro, this was like pure white. Like, wow. I've never seen something more whiter than this. Dumb white. And it just went, it's like a flash. Boom.
Yeah.
And all I heard was the electric outlets and stuff like that go, right? And everything shut down for a second. Computers, the lights, everything, boom. Shut down, went back on. And then all the customers, because it was full house, customers and stuff was like, yo, y'all seen that? And I'm like, yeah, y'all seen that? I'm not the one bugging, right? White light, everyone said the same thing. White light, electric current. And I asked a lot, but one of the people that was facing the kitchen was like, yeah, I saw a white light going to the kitchen. And I was like, no way. So I asked Chalapo, the chef was like, yeah, yo, I saw a white lightning just go a car across the grill. And then Chalapo was like, whoa.
Wow.
Yeah, it just went like a lightning.
A flash.
Really? I don't know, bro.
Speed of light. But someone probably went through. You went.
Bro, you don't understand. I saw the light come like, towards me, like, just blink. But then it disappeared, right? And then the customers in the front told me that it went past them and went to the kitchen. Oh, I was like, yo, that's an electric current, bro.
Yeah,
but crazy. It was quick, yo. It was just quick. It was like, boom, boom. And it was just once. Bro, I was so scared for a second.
I mean, that's one thing I'm getting I get scared about.
What, lightning?
Getting hit by a lightning.
Because I'm like, ah, fuck.
Too goofy.
Yeah, but that was the story. But yeah, guys, so we're gonna conclude a little bit early today and we're gonna go rap maybe like 2-3 songs.
We do like
we'll do two songs,
yeah.
We'll do two songs. Sonny, you can choose a beat.
No, you choose, put anything. I've been picking the beats.
Oh, yeah, what beat? Oh man, I don't know what beats to.
Funny, I'd be nice with it.
Because
it's all about you, it's about freestyle beat, instrumental.
Okay.
Just click anything. That's what I do.
The instrumental. Yeah, guys. So let's go. We have 5 minutes in this. Let's shoot some funny ones. Let's see this one. So much ads.
Ads.
Oh, let's test our vocabulary skills today.
What? Sitting on the beat, you know what I is. I go skeet skeet, kissing my girl on the hip, slapping her freaking bitch, looking like neat and a snitch.
Lilo and Stitch.
Hey.
On my dick. Punch your hip. I do some squats. If you acting tough.
Yeah. 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 Acting so tough.
Acting so tough.
It's not a bluff. Look at you. Looking like what? Looking like Cheetos. That is a puff. I'm gonna puff, puff, blow you down. Out here from out of town. In here where you're around. Out here you're not around. Telling the truth, huh? I just be sitting in the booth. I'm not no Abe Lincoln, but I be driving a Lincoln. Driving so fast down in the road. You be croaking out here just like a toad. Ribbit, ribbit, come like a toad, huh?
Come ribbit, like a ribbit, come like a toad.
Yeah.
Bitch, your neck look like a toad.
Hey!
Girl so pretty.
Yes, yes, yes.
I cut my ass cheek. Ew, that's kind of sus.
Yeah.
I don't know why I said that.
Yeah.
If a girl acting cute, I'ma probably kiss her.
Okay.
Text her so many times, I probably miss her.
Okay. Yeah.
Miss her so much.
Miss her so much.
Touch her hips.
Okay.
Lick her booty.
Okay.
Then she lick mine.
Oh, what?
Hey, yo.
Yo, pause.
Hey, yo.
Pause. Taking a pause. Huh. A round of applause. Like clap, clap. I'm clapping her cheeks. Huh. Like Sandy cheeks. What? SpongeBob to the square pants. I'm getting them cheeks. Huh. You just be Patrick Star. Coming out here with a. What? I just be coming out here. Like I just came out the bar. Took a few sips. Huh. I'm feeling clean. I be doing like 350. I'm doing hand cleans. Oh!
Learn about crypto. That's not and bad. Hey, hey, hey,
chill, chill with that. All right, all right.
Let's last see. One?
Last one, last one. That's not bad.
Whatever we said, that should go to TikTok. Sus. I feel like those the sus is being the sus is trendy.
Is this, bro? Oh, like Adam Ross. Not trendy.
We do, yo, we put it on TikTok.
Yeah, man, I'm telling you, bro.
Sus raps.
Yo, we, all the videos?
Just yeah, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna start putting more on TikTok. I gotta, you, it's just the opposite, all right, bet.
What was that? That was, I don't like that.
Ooh, bet. We're gonna keep on going. We're not gonna stop.
Okay.
You wanna go first?
Yeah.
No, I'll go first. I'll go first.
I bet.
I'm becoming saucy, yeah. Getting saucy, yeah. Yeah. Getting saucy, yeah. You know I'm a boss, yeah.
Yeah.
Eating Ross. You kinda sus, hey. Yeah. But you make me wanna be sus, yeah. Riding the bus. I give two bus.
Hey.
Pow, pow, pow.
Pow.
Shoot you in your face.
Uh-huh. Bah.
Call you brace face.
Hey.
So much metals. I'ma eat you up like
pebbles. I just be stepping on what? Stepping on rocks to pebbles. You know, just I just be riding my shit on the table. I mean the table. I got me digital art. I bought it on cable. That shit on D-Man. I'm not no demon. I'm coming out here cause I got a message. I just be preaching. Coming out every season. I'm in Sazon. I be just pulling the salt on my cream. Cream the sour to cream. Cream of the crop. Me and my homies, we taking our top off.
Hey, taking our top off. But your girl, she topped me off.
Hey.
Call her Kylie Jenner. Yo. Sipping on lean.
Sipping on what?
All my boys, son, you kinda mean.
Kinda mean, mean, mean.
Not really mean. Only mean to bitches.
Aye.
I like my dudes. Ayo, that's kinda sussy.
Sussy. I just be rocking the shirt like it's Stussy. I stay on the top. You know, I keep me a rock. I keep me a Glock. Keep me a 19. 19 to 40. 19 to 45, just stop me a world war like. Got me a gun, machine. G to the K, MGT to the K. I just playing this T to the face. Look at my meat, T to the what? Sonny just finished the line. Coming out here, I be stopping the crime. Coming out here, I be stepping in the line like.
Stepping on line, get out my way.
punch you in your dime. Get out of my way. Always get these backs off.
All right, you start the next one. The last one.
That was not bad. That was not bad. Oh, was it at Dragon Ball Z?
Anyways, this has copyright claims, so who cares?
All right. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. Come on, Sonny. Last one, bro.
Yo, I'm about to go hype.
Yeah.
Sitting in this chair, I'm about to go pipe a bitch.
Hey.
Pop your bitch. Yo, me and my boys, we out here sitting at the table, smoking some coke. Hey, we don't do that, but your bitch, she on my dick. She trying to get some neat.
Hey.
Make my bed. After that, go brush my teeth.
Hey.
Hey. Then a pretty bitch with a nice lip.
Hey.
Sit in her face with my freaking nice ass. Hey, gender roles, we switching.
Gender roles, I don't be talking about roles, but you know I be cupping a rose. Yeah, got me a new Rolls Royce out here with the eat the rice. Like, give me a plate out here, trying to just go on a date. Everyone knows I just be coming in early, never too late, never too late, cause I'm coming early. Everyone knows I'm sturdy, coming out here and I'm sturdy, coming out here with a birdie. Got me a dot, keep me a DOT, got me a Department of Transportation, you know me. Taking a bus down to the train, out here just giving me brain. I just be coming so quick, I just be feeling the rain. I just be feeling so rain so fast, coming out here trying to bass. Trying to just bass, 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 bass. Trying to the bass, I just be trying to bust. You know, I just be trying to bust. I just saw a China bus, ching ching China bus.
China bus, China bus. Me and my boys, we kinda iffy.
Yeah.
So hard, call us stiffy. I probably lift a bitch up, pick her up. Hope she weigh 30 pounds, cause that's how much I could probably lift her up. Yo, sipping cups.
Yeah, yeah.
I'ma go pop, pop.
He gon' pop, pop. I'ma pop off. Everyone knows I be killing the bitch. Pop off. Yeah. Feel so good, feel so great. I feel like I'm number 9, minus 1 is 8. Count to number 10. I'm 11, 12. Chillin' out here with the after fucking 12s.
Hey. After 12s. After 12s. Sit in your bed, eat some donuts. You pig. I'ma call you pig. Pig.
Yo.
Woo. I keep getting flash flood award.
Oh, man. Yoda.
This is dangerous and a life-threatening situation. Damn, bro. Chill out, bro.
Yo, us rapping is a life-threatening situation, bro. I was dying here. Yo, your raps is getting good, bro.
Really?
Yeah, that's not bad. But Sonny, that's not bad. Guys, rate Sonny's rap, bro. Rate his rap. That's not bad. Comment down below. Yo, our podcasts are getting amazing, bro. And next week, for sure, we're going to have a guest.
Yes.
And if not, bro, I'll have a backup. That's okay, the thing.
Bye.
So we'll have a backup. Because I know Wednesday is the only time that we'll have the thing. But Sonny's tired for today. You said that.
Yeah,
this video I'm going to edit, so I'm definitely going to put that. Most of it's time I spend at bars. But close it off, Sonny.
Yeah, guys, make sure to follow us on our TikTok. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new. We got 40 subscribers.
Amen.
So thank you for that. And yeah, guys, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe. Shout out to everyone that's watching us. So, yeah, like always, see you guys on our next episode. Peace.
Peace.
And it goes a little something like...